Hey everyone, welcome back to Miniature Painting 101, a series of videos where I teach you all about miniature painting in at least 101 parts. This is part 39, Rotting Flesh. Basically, you can apply this as rotting flesh or zombie flesh, however you want to call it. As requested by you guys, a specific subscriber asked me to do some rotting flesh as opposed to making a zombie cultist. So we're going to take our cultist from a previous Miniature Painting 101 series and we're going to add some rotting flesh to make him look a little more zombie-esque. For this tutorial, you can apply this color scheme to the entire flesh scheme, but I like to combine it with normal flesh to combine an interesting color scheme. Today we'll be using Strachan Green, a combination of Athonian Camo Shade and Reclan Flesh Shade, Nurgling Green, and an optional step is Nurgle's Rot, a really cool new color from the Citadel range, which I will be doing a full video on in a future video. So we're going to start off with Strachan Green, and we're going to, of course, thin it down because we want this color to amalgamate with the nice flesh tones that we've previously worked on the model. Now, as I mentioned, you can just do this color scheme entirely on the model, but I like to combine normal flesh and rotting flesh to make it more like, that's the kind of zombie I like to look at. My favorite zombies are the ones that have part normal from one angle, but rotten from another angle. So we're going to thin it down, get to a nice consistency, and start applying it to certain areas. And the key is you don't want to be perfect with your lines. You just want to apply it wherever you want. And the key is, in future steps, is going to be try to blend it with the skin around it. That way it looks like the surrounding area is starting to rot, and these are just the areas that are really rotten. So we're going to take our thin down Strachan Green. Now, as you can see, it's quite thin down, and it's going to gel really well with the normal flesh color scheme that we worked on so well in the previous Miniature Painting 101. And as I said, apply it to wherever you want. You could be as much or as little as you want on the skin. Just up to you. As you can see, I'm going to try to keep it in like blobs. I don't want to have nice fixed lines. I want it to just really nicely blend with the skin around it. And it doesn't go over perfectly, as you can see, and that's what we're going for. We want it to slightly blend. And now that it's done, we're going to do a 2-to-1 mix of Athonian Camo Shade, which is that Nurgling Green shade, and Reclan Flesh Shade, which is the normal flesh shade. And that way, and I did thin it down a little bit after that, so now we're going to get that little bit reddish, pinkish tint to the green, and that adds that rotting flesh texture to these areas. And feel free to add as much or as little as you want. I do thin it down a little bit because I don't want to overwhelm the parts that I'm painting. But, as I said, you apply as much as little as you want. This part will really make the recesses look rotting, and that's what we're going for here. It adds really nice rotting texture to these areas. And if you're unhappy after it dries, feel free to do a second one. Just make sure the first one's completely dry before proceeding to the second shading. And when that was dry, I went over it again, once again, with a watered-down Strachan Green, the same Strachan Green that I used in the first part. And I just wanted to pick up on the raised areas a little bit more to have a nice blend of rotting flesh. Now, these rotten flesh, you really want to have a mixture of colors to make it look like a bunch of different rotting tones and a bunch of different steps of rotting. So I'll just focus on the raised areas with Strachan Flesh just a little bit. I basically just did a quick overbrush of these areas. And then I repeated this process with Nurgling Green, which, of course, being Nurgle, you know it's about rotting. And I'm just going to go over it really quickly. Once again, focusing on all the raised areas. And, of course, trying to get a nice blend of the various rotting green tones on this miniature. So you see now he's really starting to look very zombie-ish, rotten, fleshy, and that's what I want to go for. Now he's a zombie cultist. And that's basically it. After this, you are done, if you want to be. The next step is optional. This is actually pretty good, and it does have that nice rotting flesh look, but I really want to use the new paint from the Citadel range called Nurgling Rot. Now, what it is Nurgle's Rot is essentially, it's kind of a similar skin tone. It's a little bit brighter, so it'll lighten up these rotting flesh parts, but it also has a bit of a glaze medium in there. It has a glaze texture to it, so it will dry shiny. And it's really nice, so it adds that like wet, mucousy, pus look to the rotting flesh, and that's what kind of like we're going for rotting flesh. So we're just going to take this Nurgle's Rot and apply it to all the surfaces that we've been painting, and it will, once again, as I said, it'll dry really shiny and rotten-y, and that's what we're kind of going for. I will do a miniature painting video on Nurgle's Rot by itself and discuss how to use it. in various ways. But here's what it looks like when it's dry. And now the zombie cultus is complete. And as you can see there now, there's a bit of a shiny texture to the surface. And that's what we're going for. That's that rotten, shiny look. And I believe that he definitely pulls off the zombie cultus look. He's definitely rotting with his skin tones. And I think he's going to go around eating people's brains. So thank you very much for watching this episode of Miniature Painting 101. I really hope you enjoyed it. And stay tuned for part 40, which is just around the corner. But if you can't wait for part 40, check out The Warp. Click on the link below for a free 14-day trial to my premium YouTube channel, where not only will you get to see the next 6 months worth of Miniature Painting 101 episodes, you also get to see dozens of start-to-finish painting tutorials, battle reports, and just some awesome wargaming content. So go ahead and check out The Warp. I really think you'll appreciate it. So thank you very much for watching one more time. Until next time, this is Jay saying, happy painting, everyone.